Hello, Discover Family Church. My name is Josh Roberie. I work at ARC, the Association of Related Churches, and I'm friends with your pastor, Pastor Johnny Kelly. I'm so thankful for ARC because it's through ARC I've gotten to know your pastor. You guys are ARC Church Plant number 419, and it's through working with ARC and working with the training process here that I've got to know your pastors, and I've actually followed your journey from your first day until now, and stay in touch with what's happening with you. And I'm really thrilled to have a moment to share a devotional thought with you. I'm out here on our back deck at my house, and this is one of my favorite places to spend time with God. I sit in one of these green chairs back here, drink coffee. I got my coffee cup right here. I don't know that I can actually read my Bible without having a cup of coffee because I've done it for so long at this point. And you know, it's peaceful out here. I like to be outside. I like to see the sun, the sunlight reflecting off the trees. I even enjoy the rain. And that's one of the ways that helps me relax and connect with God. And that's really what I want to spend some time talking with you about today, connecting with God in the midst of all this craziness. And right now, everything, every routine is blown up. Everything is just kind of mashed together. And you know, that someone said the other day on social media that they spent all day Saturday thinking it was Friday because all the days just are kind of running together right now. And that's kind of how it is in our homes. Our homes are our office, it's our school, it's our daycare, it's our family home, it's our kids' playground because they can't really go do too much with other people right now. And it can kind of be chaotic at times. And I want to talk about developing routine in your time connecting with God. And some people, you know, in every marriage, there's the routine person and there's the non-routine person. You know, there's a person who rolls up the toothpaste and then there's the person who just squeezes it, right? And in our family, my marriage, I am not the routine person. My wife is so good at routine. And when things kind of get crazy, she buckles down on the routine. And for me, when things get crazy, it's kind of an opportunity to kind of get away from the routine, right? But I think when it comes to connecting with God, keeping that routine going is very, very important. And I want to give you a tool in your spiritual toolbox to help you with that routine. And it's called SOAP. And the SOAP stands for Scripture, Observation, Application, and Prayer. And it's a devotional strategy that will help you be consistent and build some routine around your time with God. And you know, for me, one of the things I do even before I get to SOAP is I read a paper Bible and I journal in a paper journal. And I journal so I can stay consistent and I can write down what God's speaking to me and I can come back to it later and it can encourage me later. Also, writing helps me process it a little bit. And the reason why I use a paper Bible is because I love technology, I love social media and the apps and all that. But those things can become a distraction to me when I'm trying to spend time with God. I'll be on my phone reading my Bible or on my computer. An alert will come up and before I know it, I'm off track. So I like to use a paper Bible and a paper journal, and I like to write things down as I feel God speaks to me. So let's talk about the SOAP strategy and how to do it. So the first letter, S, stands for Scripture. And so when I'm reading my Bible, I'll read, and then when something kind of jumps off the page at me, I may not fully know what it means yet, but I'll write down that Bible reference. And that's exactly what happened to me today as I was reading Matthew chapter 2. You know, this is the story of the wise men visiting Jesus. And after they had come to Jesus, he was just a little baby boy, a little toddler at this point. They brought him gifts, and then they had a dream that where God told them to go back a different way than they came to Jesus. And the order of the words there just kind of spoke to me. It says in verse 12, "And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way." That's Matthew chapter 2, verse 12. And the thought of them departing another way after coming to Jesus just jumped off on the page of me. So I wrote that down. And then in SOAP, you write down the scripture. The next thing you write down is observation. This doesn't have to be deep or spiritual. It's just what is literally happening in that passage, just to process it a little bit. So I wrote down my observation. I said, they came to Jesus one way, and after spending time in his presence, they left another way. And then comes the A, the application. So the scripture is the reference. You write that down, the observation, what's literally happening. And then the application. How can I apply this verse to my life today? And this is what I wrote. The presence of God should leave me changed. It is the place I go to when I need a new direction. See, those wise men traveled to Jesus, and once they spent time with him, it changed them. He gave them a new direction for their life, and they left going in a new way. And I looked at that and I said, you know, I feel like, you know, God needs to be the place where I get my direction. Not the news, not social media, not the opinions of others, but I need to get my direction from God. I need the presence of God, because the presence of God is where I come to be adjusted, to get my compass set every day before I go about my life. And so the P is for prayer. And what you do is, you don't have to write out your whole prayer to God, but I like to write at least one or two sentences of the general idea of what I'm seeking God for that day. And so today I wrote this. I said, Lord, help me to not forget the importance of spending time in your presence. Your presence changes me and gives me direction. What is it that you would like to change in me today? What direction would you like to give me? And then what I did after that is I just waited, and I waited to hear from God. And I believe that he gave me some new direction and something that he wants me to change to be a better reflection of him. And I wrote those things down. And that's the SOAP strategy: scripture, observation, application, prayer. Helps us to keep a routine going when all the routines are kind of messed up. And I know right now we're spending a lot of time with our family. Our kids are coming with a lot of questions about what's going on. And, you know, I don't think as a parent, you know, you need to have the answers to everything. You know, what I do is sometimes I Google stuff and I'll give them the answer if I don't know it. But there's a lot of times my kids come to me about things that are bigger than the moment, things that I can't solve in that situation. What I try to do is I try to teach them to do what these wise men did. Seek God first. And what we do is I just encourage them to pray, and I offer to pray with them. Hey, listen, I don't know the answer to that, but let's seek God and see what he says about that, and we'll trust him to lead us and guide us. And I think it's the same thing in marriage, or really even if you're single. You know, after we put our kids to bed, a lot of times my wife and I will sit on the couch and we'll talk about what's on our mind. And then we'll take time and we'll go to God for direction, and we'll seek his face about what needs to happen next. And we don't have to have all the answers. As a husband, I can't have all the answers. As a man, I'm limited. That's why I have to keep routine with seeking God, spending time in his presence. And that is where I get my direction. That's where I allow my compass to be set and the change to be set in my heart. And I go from there. So I hope that encourages you today. I hope you find a way to keep your routine going during this crazy time. And thank you for allowing me to spend some time with you today. Have a great week.